By default, you input journal data to the Journal Input Data Source member in the local currency of each entity. Optionally, you can create additional data source members that enable you to enter data in a single input currency for all entities in the journal. The consolidation member selected for the journal point of view determines whether the input currency data is treated as untranslated or already translated. If entity input is selected for consolidation, you enter untranslated data to the selected input currency. When you run the consolidate or translate business rule, the data is reverse translated from the input currency to entity currency for each entity. The data in entity currency is then translated to the parent currency for the consolidate rule, or a selected reporting currency for the translate rule, using the standard translation process. If translated currency input is selected for consolidation, you enter translated data in the selected input currency. When the journal is posted, the data is stored at the translated currency input member of the consolidation dimension. When you run the consolidate business rule, if the input currency matches the currency of the entity's parent, the value is copied from the input currency member to the parent currency member without translation. When you use the translate business rule to translate to reporting currencies, if the input currency matches the reporting currency, the value is copied to the reporting currency without translation. Translated currency input values are not reverse translated to the entity currency member, nor are they copied to entity currency, even if the input currency matches the entity currency. To create data source members for journal input currencies, open the Data Source dimension in the Dimension Editor. Add the new Data Source members under the Total Input and Adjusted member. Optionally, you can create parent members to organize your Data Source members. Here I have a parent named Total Journals with all the journal input members as its children. I'll add a Data Source member to enable users to input journal data in US dollars. I'll leave the data storage for the member set to store and the consolidation operator to addition. Select journal for the source data type. The source currency type property specifies the input currency. I'll select USD. After adding new members, you must refresh the database. If ownership management is enabled, you should also recompute ownership data. Now I'll assign the new data source member to journals. I have a journal for adjustments to checking that I've already started. Notice that the journal was created for the entity input consolidation member. In the data source list, I'll select the journal input USD member that I added. Notice that the journal currency has changed from entity currency to USD. Because the currency for the data source member selected for the journal is USD, I must enter all adjustments in US dollars, even though the journal has rows for Germany, whose local currency is euro, and United Kingdom, whose local currency is the British pound. I'll submit, approve, and post the journal. The data has been posted to the Entity Input Consolidation member, the Journal Input USD Data Source member, and the USD Currency member. Now I'll post the journal for the Translated Currency Input Consolidation member. I'll select Journal Input USD as the data source member. This journal contains line items for Canada, whose entity currency is Canadian dollar. I'll enter data in USD, which is the currency of Canada's parent entity. Now I'll submit, approve, and post the journal. The data has been posted to the Translated Currency Input Consolidation member, the Journal Input USD data source member, and the USD currency member. Let's use data forms to review the posted data. I'll look at the data posted to Germany and United Kingdom first. In the POV, the consolidation member is set to entity input, and the data source member to journal input USD. The data was posted to the USD currency member for both Germany and United Kingdom. The entity currency member currently has no data. Now I'll run the consolidate business rule for Germany and United Kingdom. The amount in the USD member was translated to the entity currency for each entity using the current period rates. The entity currency amount for each entity was then translated to parent currency using the standard translation and consolidation process. Now let's open the Cash Canada form and look at the journal data posted to translated currency input. The data was posted to the translated currency input consolidation member, journal input USD data source member, and the USD currency member. Entity currency and parent currency have no data. I'll run the consolidate business rule for Canada. If the input currency, USD, matches the currency of Canada's parent, the data in USD will be copied to the parent currency member during consolidation. The amount in USD was copied to the parent currency member without translation. No data was copied to entity currency. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.